In this video, I will consider authentication with Google OAuth API and Password.js. This could be a good alternative or addition to the classic password login. This approach can be combined with session-based or GWT authentication, which I covered in previous videos. The basic idea of using a third-party OAuth API is to delegate the user authentication process to an external service provider that we trust. As a benefit, we can improve the user experience by simplifying the login process. Additionally, we may also request access to user information and resources from this third-party platform. OAuth 2, which stands for Open Authorization Version 2, is an industry standard to implement authentication using a third-party API. Here is the OAuth flow for Google, but it will be generally the same for other providers. The application requests a token that can be used to access user resources. The user must confirm the request with their Google credentials, in which case the API returns code. The application can convert this code into a token that provides access to the user resources, including the user Google ID and profile information we need for authentication. To use the Google OAuth API, you must first create a project in the Google Cloud associated with your web application. When the project is created and selected, you need to go to API and Services page, select Credentials section, and create a new Credential OAuth Client ID. The application type will be web application. Once the OAuth Client ID is created, you can find the client's public ID and secret key on its page. You also need to set a redirect URI that will be used to pass code. We will use all this a little later in the code of the web application project. On the front-end side, I have a sign-in with Google button. This is a regular HTML link element that should lead to the Google consent screen. I prefer to generate this link on my backend, so I make an initial request to my API endpoint and get the redirect to this screen in the response. Here is what this step looks like in the context of an OAuth flow. I'm using a passport with the Passport Google OAuth strategy to interact with the Google OAuth API. Once the user is signed in using Google OAuth, further requests will be authorized using a session or GWT. Here is a Passport.js configuration that supports both session-based and GWT authentication. And at that point, I attached the Google strategy. This middleware provides an abstraction layer for interacting with the Google OAuth API. This is where an instance of the Google Strategy class is initialized. To initialize it, I am passing in the client ID and secret from the Google Credentials page we looked at earlier. The callback URL specifies the redirect path to the frontend page that should process the code retrieved from the Google API. This path must be identical to that we set up on the web client page before. This callback function can handle the response from the Google and pass it on through the done function. Passport Google strategy gets and uses access tokens implicitly to retrieve the user's profile object. We need this object to identify and authorize the user, so we pass it on. Regarding access and refresh tokens, in the common case we can store them to access other Google platform resources that the user allowed. But in the current example, I don't need this. This is the consent screen endpoint code. The Google Passport strategy with scope parameters generates a link to the consent screen and sends a redirect to it as a response. When the user accepts the required scopes, they are redirected to a callback URL with an authorization code. The target screen sends the code to the backend and waits for a response to configure the user's local authorization. This is my front-end logic for this step. Take the code from the redirect path. Send it to the backend for authentication. Handle potential errors. Set the authenticated user from the response locally. This logic of authentication endpoint. The Passport Google strategy under the hood exchange an authorization code for an access token and uses that token to obtain user profile information. In fact, most of the OAuth flow is implemented in this one line of code, where the authentication method is called. Using Google profile information, I can find existing user by Google ID or create a new one. When I have a user object, I use login service to save it in session or JWT. Essentially, Google OAuth allows us to authenticate a user. But we still need to use session or JWT to bind subsequent requests to the authenticated user. So watch my previous videos on session-based authentication and JWT if you haven't already. Thank you.